Hi, welcome to today's Google Apps for Education session. What we're going to do today is go over Gmail and how to organize your Gmail inbox. The first thing that we're going to talk about is labels. In many email programs, what you have is folders. So for instance, Outlook, what you'll have is folders. So anytime you want to organize an email, you would create folders and you would take that email and put it into a folder. So if I wanted to put that email into follow-up, there it is, it's in that folder. If I wanted to put it into the project folder, there it is, it's in that folder. The only problem is, what if I want to identify this email by two different folders? I can only put that email in one folder at a time, and so this doesn't really work. What Gmail does is it trades folders for what is called labels. So now, if I wanted to say that this email was associated with project, I could put the project label on it. If I wanted to say that this email was also associated with follow-up, I could put the follow-up label on it. Or any other label that I wanted to put on it, onto this email, I could put onto this email. So now, anytime I would search for this email, I can search by any one of these topics, and I can organize that one email that way. Let's look to see how we do this in Gmail. Here we are in Gmail, and to create a label, what you're going to do is click on the gear icon. You're going to choose settings, and then you'll choose the label link here at the top. When I click on labels, there's several options that you can do, but right now what we're going to do is we're going to scroll down and choose create new label. All right, so this label, I'm going to name it project and click on create. And when I do that, over here in my menu, we now have a project label. So let's see how that works. I'm going to go to my inbox, hear from Nelson about Team Dynamics. I'm going to put a checkbox next to it here, and I will now choose this label option. I can click this drop-down arrow and add as many labels as I want, or I can choose this one with the little folder and I can choose to move it out of the inbox and into a specific label. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to move this out of the inbox and I'm going to put it into the label named project. So when I go to my project label here in the menu, there it is. And if I open up that email, I'm going to see that it has the label project here. Now let's add another label. I'll click on labels here. And this time I choose the label one so that I can put more than one, and I'll choose today as well. I'll click on apply, and now we see that it has two labels on it, project and today. And so over here on the left, if I look in today, there it is. If I look in project, there it is. And you'll notice that the search terms appear at the top as I click between the two. So search term label colon today, there it is. Search term label colon project, and there it is. So that's how you apply labels to your emails within your Gmail inbox. The next thing that we're going to go over is filters. So we all know how coffee filters work. They will take the coffee grounds that are put into them and allow water to pass through and the coffee to pass through, but it'll retain the grounds. The same thing is true when we are working with Gmail filters. It's going to take the content that we want, in this case the water, and it's going to filter out the content that we don't want. So in this case, the little green pieces of paper are going to be filtered out. So let's see how we're going to do that in Gmail. So here we are back in email, and I'm in my inbox, and I have this email that's called Microsoft Updates. So let's create a filter that will take anything that's in the subject line that says Microsoft Updates and put it into my project folder. So again, I'll click the settings gear, I'll click the settings option, and this time I'm going to choose filters. So I'll scroll down to the bottom and choose create a new filter. And this time in the subject, I want it to say Microsoft Updates. And then I click create filter with this search. So now what do I want it to do? I want it to skip the inbox so it's no longer in the inbox. And I want to apply the label project. And if you notice down here, it says it found 20 other emails that match this. So what I can do is I can click that checkbox and it's going to go through my inbox and find those other 20 and apply this filter to it. So it'll skip the inbox and it will apply the label to project to all of these emails. I'll click on create filter and let's see how that works. So now if I click on project, there it is. I've gotten all of the emails that say Microsoft Updates, so I can work with those within my project label. Now that we've created some labels and some filters to filter out our emails into those labels, let's look at the menu and see how we can adjust the menu to fit our needs. All right, so now we're over here and we're in the menu, and the menu item has some items that are non-changeable. You can't do anything about them. So I have a sent mail. You'll notice that I don't have a drop arrow there. I have a draft mail. I have no drop arrow there. But when I get down to the project one that I created, I do have a drop arrow. If I hit that drop arrow, it gives me several options. I can show, show if unread, or hide. If I choose show, it will always be in the menu. If I choose show if unread, the only time it's going to be in the menu is if within that label there is an email that is unread. And the last one is hide. No matter what, if you choose this one, it will be hidden unless you hit the more button down here. So let's choose show if unread. All right, so now that disappeared because all of those Microsoft updates were read. So let me choose one of these. I'll click on this latest one, go to my more option and choose mark as unread. And now this appears within my menu. That label has returned. And if I read this email, if I click on this email and read it, you'll notice that the label disappears. So that's how that show if unread works. That way you can keep a very simplified menu of only showing you the most important things that you need to deal with on a day-to-day basis. And when important things do appear into your other labels because of the filters you set, they'll appear there as well. All right, so we learned some great things, ways to organize our inbox within Gmail. The last feature that I want to talk about is the search. Gmail is based on the Google search engine, so this is a very powerful tool. It searches your email as fast as Google searches the internet. Some people are so good at using the search, they don't use any of the other tools. Let's take a look. All right, I'm back in my inbox, and up here in the search bar, there's a little drop arrow. If I click that drop arrow, I have several options. So I can search emails from, emails to, emails that contain a word in the subject line, emails that have words anywhere in the email, or do not have specific words in an email, emails that have attachments, emails but don't include charts. I can choose emails of a certain size, and I can choose a date range. So this is my favorite one. Let's see, I'm looking for something to do with golf. I remember there's a golf clinic a long time ago, and I know it was probably about almost 10 years, 8, 9, 10 years ago. Let's try July, so 7/26/2015. Nope, not 2015. Let's try 2006. There we go. And I do that search. And there it is. It says golf anytime after July 25th, 2006 and before July 28th, 2006. And there it is. I found that email about the golf clinic. So now I can research what was done during that time. So again, Gmail search searches as fast as a Google searches the internet. So it's a very powerful tool to look through your Gmail account and find those emails that you're looking for. Well, this wraps up today's Google Apps for Education session. I hope to see you again next week.